What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to Tactical Advantage. Today we're going to take a look at my CZ Scorpion EVO 3 S1. A few months back, we actually posted a video where we're doing the first shots on the suppressor that's on this gun, and I got a couple questions on how I set it up. So I figured I'd make a quick video on kind of what I've done to this gun. Not a whole lot, actually, but figured we'd just run it through real quick. So we'll start at the back, where we have the Gearhead Works Tailhook Mod 1. On the gearhead works adapter, the OEM folding assembly, which just works really nice. It works with the lines of the gun. It doesn't go straight back, so it actually lifts the platform up a little bit. So definitely dig this. It folds real well, locks in real well. We have the yetiwurks switchback grip on the thin kind of setup, OEM sights, HBI magazine release. Definitely like this. The yetiwurks I kind of like too, but it's a little bit too oversized in my opinion. And I'm not a big fan of their logo. Like the HBI is just muted. It just has like an HBI kind of engraved in it, but works really, really well. I do have the yetiwurks blizzard trigger in this, which I'm probably going to change out. The one thing that I'm kind of not digging is it's obviously a flat face. But the sides are so abrupt and it's so flat right here, it tends to not be comfortable on the finger if you're running the gun for, you know, a long period of time. So I like the trigger. I like the trigger feel, but it definitely needs some chamfering, or we're going to try something else. I haven't really figured out what I'm going to do there yet. Factory safeties in it. They don't really bother me that bad. It does kind of dig into the finger, but I just haven't gotten annoyed enough yet to change it. We do have the HB Industries trigger spring kit in here, which cleans up the trigger a lot from the factory kind of setup. But you know, you could definitely get away with the factory setup. We'll go ahead and flip her this way. Got the Holosun 503G with the ACSS reticle in it. Good setup. I like the Holosuns. They've been reliable for me. I've got just a bunch of different red dots from them. And this seems to work pretty well. I like the ACSS, even though when you set it up at zero magnification, it's not quite as useful. It kind of muds up because it's so small. Under magnification, I definitely dig that reticle. But at like, you know, single power, you know, it's cool. It does its job, but it doesn't really give you all the functionality. Really past that, the overall gun when I bought it was just a blank back, or actually it came with the SB Tactical folder, changed out for this, put the SB Tactical folder on my other Evo. So this one past that, you know, stock bolt release, stock sights. I did the camo myself, made the stencils myself, and just did it in like a winter kind of camo. So nothing really crazy there. I kind of chose more like muted grays just because when it's dirty, as you can see, it's dirty as all get out. But it kind of still looks right. It doesn't, you know, not so much white that it looks bad. It's more grays. Really, that's it. The last thing we did was the rugged obsidian 45 on a fixed barrel mount. This thing has been really good to us so far. Great, great, great suppressor, at least in my experience. That's why I really chose the pistol with the long carbine forend, just because I saw, I believe it was Military Arms Channel, Max, shout out to you, running this same gun with like an Omega 9K with the suppressor tucked, and it just looked and worked really, really well. So that's why I chose this setup. But here's a closer look at the rugged. So definitely good looking. And you can kind of chop back into the K configuration. But that's really it, guys. Not a whole bunch to it. Gun runs great. No issues so far at all with it. Suppressed, unsuppressed. Eats whatever ammo you throw at it. So been a really good gun. So see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.